The Hubble Space Telescope is humanity's eye into the history of the universe. I'm here with Dr. Feustel, one of Purdue's alumni astronauts who served on the last Hubble mission. Dr. Feustel, it's nice to meet you.
Hi, Kyle. How are you doing today?
Good.
Good to see you.
Can you tell us a little bit about an overview of the mission and what your individual part of was in the mission?
I can. The mission was about 11 days long, a little over that because we hung out in space for a few days waiting for the weather to clear in Florida. But an 11-day mission to the Hubble Space Telescope. It was the last servicing mission to the Hubble. It was actually the fifth servicing mission done by astronauts, but I won't get into the naming convention at this time. But we performed five EVAs, or spacewalks, on the mission, and repaired two scientific instruments, replaced two scientific instruments, and installed some batteries and gyros for pointing and navigation of the telescope.
Now, I know you train a lot to be an astronaut, especially for mission-specific contingents, so something goes wrong. You have a little bit more about what to do, and you've trained for it. Was there any difficulties in this mission you hadn't really thought of ahead of time, or you encountered when you were trying to service the Hubble?
Yeah, we actually had some challenges every day, primarily with the spacewalks, and they were all things that we hadn't planned for. Fortunately, though, during the 2.5 years of training, we did cover a lot of different contingencies, so that allowed us to make up for those challenges that we saw during the mission sort of build in some real-time fixes to the problems that we saw. But we do train a lot of the contingencies. Fortunately, we saw none of those, but we saw new ones. So Hubble had a new surprise every day for us.
Here we have some images from some of the early release observations from the Hubble after you serviced the Hubble. How does it feel to know that you helped bring humanity these images?
It's extremely rewarding. I can tell you that, one of the things we're most proud of is that we didn't break the telescope. You know, that's the number one goal when you're out there doing the work. But, to see these images and be able to peer into deep space really gives you a huge satisfaction to know that the Hubble Space Telescope is really an observatory looking deep into space and showing us what's out there, those images and the properties of the universe that we would never otherwise have any clue about really what the makeup is and what's going on out there. So it's very rewarding. The images are spectacular, and I think Hubble's going to continue to return those images to us, hopefully for another 5 to 15 years.
I know your mind was a lot on the mechanical aspect of the mission, repairing the Hubble, getting the job done. Did you ever have any time just to kind of think about, you were in space, get a chance to look around and kind of just take in the experience?
Yeah, every day we tried to take an opportunity to look around and see where we were. And I think one of the things we talked about before the mission was reminding each other while we were outside in the spacesuits working on the telescope to stop and look around. For me, it was being able to look over the Earth in the great distance and be able to see Michigan and Indiana off in the distance. And I've got some great pictures of that. And it's really spectacular. And you try to pinch yourself each time you're out there and say, wow, I'm really out here in space, and we're doing this work, and we're trying to do great things. So it's a pretty special environment.
Now, what's your future career aspirations with NASA? Do you have any long-term research plans or anything you're going towards individually?
I'd like to actually go to the moon, and I may be a little bit too old for that, but if I can't go to the moon, then I'd like to be involved with missions, planning missions to the moon and all the operations and exploration that would go on in association with that that sort of activity.
Well, thanks a lot. It's been a great pleasure talking to you.
You bet.
I'm Kyle Cray for Boiler Bytes.